Hi everyone, my name is Glenda with SureFit Designs. In this video, I'm going to talk about designing a garment without a side seam using princess lines. Let's take a look at Miss Molly Mannequin here. I'm going to show you a couple of ideas. This first one is showing you a princess line that's coming out of the arm side, right here. And because it's coming out of the arm's eye, it's not going over the fullest part of the bust line. And so therefore, it requires the remainder of the shaping to be done with this little short dart. I actually have a playlist of a number of different videos on how to do the princess line, and one of them is showing you exactly how to do that little shorty dart. As we continue to look at the test garment here, you'll notice that there is no side seam, and the next seam that you see is coming out of the back arm side right here. Any shaping that you do needs to happen on this seam and on this front seam right there. All right, let's take a look at one more test garment here. We'll get Miss Molly redressed with this sample. That looks pretty good. All right. Now, as we take a look at this garment, you'll see that the princess line is coming out of the mid-shoulder, going over the apex, and then down to the waistline. This actually is my favorite. It gives one of the very best shapes that you'll ever get with a princess line because it's going over the top of your apex at the level of your apex. Again, you'll see that there is no side seam And there is also the next seam is coming out of the back armhole area. Again, shaping is done on these two seams right here. Now, the fashion garment that I'm wearing, this vest, is an example of this particular design line. So you can see the princess line coming out of the shoulder line over the apex for that excellent shaping and going down into the hemline. As I lift up my arm, there is no side seam. And there is the back seam coming out of the back arm side. This is actually a reversible vest. I put in a separating reversible zipper. The inside is done with fleece and the outside is done with fashion fabric. Let's carry on now and take a look at what to do with the pattern. When you have your body blueprint drawn, you're going to end up with a bodice front and a bodice back in this orientation. But because we want to join those side seams together, I need to change the orientation of the back of the pattern. And that's very easy to do. All you're going to do is flip the pattern over so that it looks like this. And now your side seams are facing one another. All right, what I want to do though right now is move the back out of the demonstration area just for the time being, because I'd like to focus on the bodice front. So we need to draw some design lines. And I'm going to draw the variation that I'm wearing with the princess line going through the shoulder line. And so first of all, you'll take your shoulder line and measure it and then divide it in half like that. You will then take your designing stylus and draw from the shoulder line down to the apex, so it will look like that. Now, because some of the shaping is going to come from this waist-fitting dart, you will now extend this line to the side edge of that waist-fitting dart and from your apex down to that side edge of the waist-fitting dart. And so that's actually going to become your seam line. Now, before I cut this out and separate these two pieces, I do need to make matching notches approximately 2 inches above and below where your apex currently is a good place to put in your matching notches. And one other thing that you're going to need to know is where is the grain line on this side panel? So just draw a parallel grain line that is parallel to the existing grain line, like this. And now I also should mention that when you do this designing, please make sure that you do it without seam allowances. So this pattern is called a strip down pattern. Your seam allowances simply don't get in the way when you're doing all of the design work, but that does mean that at the end you need to add seam allowances all the way around. So now we're going to pretend that I've cut on that design line, and this is what the center front panel will now look like. And I have done this in red so that it will really stand out for you. And we'll put another little pin right down here to hold it in place. And the side panel looks like this. I'll pin that in place. And again, you can see that these red design lines now are following down the side edges of that waist fitting dart. And that's so that when, again, this has been cut apart, when you sew that together, that will nip and shape in at the waistline. But now we have one more thing that we need to deal with, and that is this bust fitting dart. So in order to pivot that bust dart closed, what you do need to draw are, so let me get the stylus to do that. You need to draw what is called the designer's dart, and you draw from, I've got a pin in my way there, you draw from the beginning of your dart at the side seam up to your apex like this. And I'm doing it in green so that you can see it standing out and being different. And then what you will do is cut that designer's dart out and then rotate and pivot that shoulder portion down to meet that line right here. And when that's completed, it will look like this. So here I have it sitting over here in green. So you can see it was just taking that shoulder and rotating it down. And if I take this piece off really quickly, and I'll just put this over there, then as I take this side panel and put it in place like that, you can see how your bust dart now has closed up on the side seam and opened up in the shoulder line. So you get that same good fit no matter where you put it going around your bust line. But so that I don't have a lot of confusing lines here, I'm just going to set that side panel portion here. So there's center front and the side panel portion. All right, now we're going to take a look at the back bodice, and I'll move this a little bit further over into the line of the camera here so that you can see what's happening. There's the back bodice, and you know, I did flip the pattern over so that the orientation was that the side seams would now go together. And that's so easily done. You know, when you're working with the SureFit Designs tracing vellum, this is almost a totally see-through product. It is transparent enough that even when you're drawing in pencil, you can flip it one side to the other and still see your lines, which is a really, really great feature of it. Another great feature is that you can erase to your heart's content and this will not go into holes. I know if you haven't tried the tracing vellum before that you're really going to love it. So now what we need to do is take a look at the design line that needs to be put on the bodice back. We're going to work in the armhole, and you come up about midway, and then you're going to mark over approximately a half an inch and make yourself a little guide mark. And then you're going to take the distance in between your side waist point and the side edge of that dart and mark halfway. Then we're going to actually do a curve line going into the armhole, but I'm going to use that mark and this mark as my guideline to get the design feature going. So I'm going to come up approximately that high. And then what I will do is take the designing stylus, turn it around so that I've got that curved edge and come into the armhole. So that gave me the design feature. Now before I can cut that part away from the center back portion, I do need to make matching notches. So on this panel, I will do double notches. And then the other thing that you need to do is the same thing as I did on the front, is transfer and put a parallel grain line over on the side panel, so that it looks like that. So that grain line is parallel to that grain line. And now what you're going to do is, again, cut open on that design line, and here's what the center back panel will look like. When that is completed, I'll put a couple of pins in here to hold this in place. And the side panel looks like this, and it would just sit right here. Now, again, remember I'm doing this without seam allowances. So now what you've done is you cut on that design line, make sure you transfer your matching notches, and now you want to take this piece and join it together with your side front panel. And your underarm is going to be your pivot point right here. And you can see that now I can pivot that side panel on the back going towards the side panel on the front. Now, if I just go ahead and join the side seams like that, you can see what's happening to the grain lines is they're no longer parallel. And you don't really want that, because then if you left the grain lines like this and just put a new grain line down the center, then what would happen is the grain on this fabric piece, on that pattern piece, would not be in the same proportion or place that the grain line is on the front panel or the back center panel. So what you really want to do is you want to make sure that these grain lines, this one to this one, are absolutely parallel. Now, when you're working on a grain board at home, of course, this is much easier on this display board. I'll just take a ruler and make sure that they are parallel, and they're pretty close. And then what you want to do is draw this pattern piece off one more time, and it will look like this. And that's the pattern piece right there. Now, in order to show it to you, I need to clear this portion of the board, and I'll put the finished pattern piece in this empty space here. There we go. And now this is what your underarm portion, underarm pattern piece, will actually look like. And so all that I've done is drawn around this with another piece of tracing vellum, and from the underarm point straight down is where I drew the new straight of grain. And notice that I've extended out and put the matching notches in place right here on the front, and on the back the double matching notches are there. Now this little option here is actually the side seam on the back. And so that's going to join together this way. And it just depends how much shaping that you want in the back, whether you join the actual pieces together or whether you shape down in that area and form a dart structure. That's kind of up to you. When I was doing the vest that I'm currently wearing, I didn't want hardly any shaping in the back of the vest, but I did in the front of the vest. And so you have that option to nip that side seam in. And then of course, the very, very last thing that you need to do is make sure that you've added seam allowances. And I'll just lay this over top. And I know there's a lot of lines going underneath, but basically what you're going to do to all of your pieces is add the 5/8 inch seam allowance. And that's very easily done with the SureFit Designs Designing Stylus, because it does have these 5/8 inch seam allowance slots, and all you're going to do is put your pencil lead against the edge that is nearest the outside edge, and that is a 5/8 inch allowance space. So that's how easy it is to put the seam allowances in place. You would just lay the stylus in and draw through. So you can see how easy and ultimately rewarding this will be to do a bodice without a side seam. First of all, when you use SureFit Designs, it's going to be fit exactly to your body measurements. And secondly, when you do this princess line, it's going to fit over your bust line. I do invite you to hop on over to SureFitDesigns.com or the SureFit Designs Learning Center and go to the video library. You're going to see all kinds of videos to help you get the best fit possible with fitting, designing, and sewing with your SureFit Designs patterns. And while you're there, I do invite you to join the SureFit Designs community. And how do you do that? Well, in three easy steps. Number one, sign up for the newsletter. You're going to get email updates as well as free gifts to get you started. Number two, make sure you to subscribe to my YouTube channel. And number three, like this video. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you again next time.